Hi everyone, today we're going to be doing the minimum speed test on the ZWF. Now if you don't know it, the minimum speed test is basically we run a normal course on cycle but with the lowest possible speed selected. So in this case it's 800 RPM. Obviously we don't select no spin because, well, fairly self-explanatory why. So, the reason we do this is to see if the machine adapts the cycle at all to the lower speed, and if it does, how it adapts it. So I'm going to be doing bedding today. I normally do this with clothes, however the only clothes that I got left to do, I want to put on Eco 4060 to see how full length Eco 4060 works with a small load, which I'm also going to film, so you should see that soon, if not before this video. So yeah, it's not a massive load of bedding, because I've already done, literally just before this, I did the other half of the bedding on half length dark colour 60. So the rest of the bedding is going to go in here. Now obviously it's not going to sense particularly high. In fact, I think it will sense this to minimum length. Yeah, well, it would 100% sense that to minimum. So I'm going to add some fairy non-bio. I'll add about this much, which is about, what is that, 25-30 mil? More than I'd normally add, but last wash, which was a bigger load than this, I didn't get a lot of suds, so I think I'm still learning what dosages to do with what. Because obviously I had to return to Fairy from Surf, which I discussed in a community post. So, cotton. Obviously we're going to be doing 60. I'm going to go down to 800 RPM, and it doesn't adjust the time at all. Whereas if you do this on Eco 4060, it does add 5 minutes. If you adjust the time to, if you adjust the speed to 1000 or 800, it will go up to 3010 from 3005. However, on cotton it doesn't. So I may do the minimum speed test on Eco 4060 off camera in future to see why that is. But we're going to follow the trend at the moment of the other two machines that have done the minimum speed test and just do normal cotton. So yeah. I'm not going to add fabric softener to this. I'm just going to leave it as it is with the fairy. The energy meter is in place, just out of curiosity, with a slightly smaller load on 60 to see how much that uses. So yeah, off we go. There we go. So no changes to the cycle, no changes to the spin patterns either. All the same, except with the boosts, it just didn't boost to 1100 or 1400. It just stayed at 800. So yeah, overall, probably closer to what LG did than to what the IZ did, because the IZ, when you lower the speed on the IZ, it keeps the final spin the exact same length, but the time that it would take to get to the higher speeds, it would include that in to how long it spins at the thing, whereas the ZWF, it has the exact same length holds as it would at the higher speeds, but just at 800 instead. For example, it spent the 1 minute at 800, where it would spend the 1 minute at 1100, and then it does the normal 65 second hold on when it got back up to 800 on the main burst of the final spin. And the LG holds for surprisingly less time on 400 RPM than it would on 800 or 1400 RPM on the final spin of that. And as I said, the IZ holds for longer. I think it was about 5 minutes or something it spent at 700 RPM. Can't remember exactly. So yeah, as I say, didn't do anything really. Let's check spin performance. Now obviously they're still quite wet from only 800 RPM. As for rinse performance, it's actually about the same as normal, so that's very good from the on the ZWF to have about the same rinse performance as usual, because it's done 800 RPM in terms here with only two rinses, instead of the usual 1100 RPM in terms and 2-3 rinses. So yeah, that's quite good. Other than that, nothing really else to say. Let's do energy usage out of curiosity. And that is 0.971 kilowatt hours. So, yeah, not too bad. Yeah, as I say, nothing else to say really. So thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then please give a like. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.